Hi friends, today our topic is armature reaction. So first of all, what is armature reaction? So it is the effect of armature flux on the main field flux is called armature reaction. The effect of armature flux on the main field flux is called armature reaction. So what are the consequences of this armature reaction? Okay, let us see today. Okay, first of all, so let us assume a DC machine. Okay, this is a rotor and there are two poles. Okay, let us assume there are two poles and this will be N and this will be S. Okay, so there is a flux, main field flux, from north pole to south pole like this. Okay, from north pole to south pole like this. So let us consider this is under no load condition. Okay, under no load condition, so the main field flux is from north pole to south pole. So this is the axis and this combines the two poles, so it is called the polar axis. So this is also called as D-axis. Okay, this is also called as D-axis. So in DC machine, if you consider two poles like this, so the brushes are opposite to this polar axis. So these two are the brushes. Okay, and we define two axes, that is GNA and MNA. Okay, so one is GNA. So GNA is nothing but a geometrical nodal axis. Okay, geometrical nodal axis. It is the axis which is always perpendicular to polar axis. Okay, so if it is the polar axis, so GNA is always perpendicular to polar axis. Okay, and it is also called as commutation axis. Okay, because the commutation process takes place along this axis. Okay, and this is also called as brush axis. Okay, so because the brushes are placed along GNA. Okay, and if it is D axis, and this will be Q axis obviously, so D axis and Q axis are perpendicular. Okay, and this is a polar axis. Okay, so one is GNA and another one is MNA, that is magnetically neutral axis. Magnetically neutral axis is always perpendicular to resultant flux. Is always perpendicular to air gap flux. Okay, so under no load condition, the air gap flux is like this. So the MNA is also perpendicular to this main field flux. So MNA is also this axis. So under no load condition, okay, under no load condition in DC machine, so GNA and MNA will coincide each other. Okay, so if you draw the phasor diagram, so this is a main field flux is like this in this direction. So let us consider phi f is in this direction, and if you write, if you draw the axes as GNA and MNA, these will be like this, GNA and MNA. So is perpendicular to phi f. Okay, so this is also called as D-axis. So phi f is along D-axis and this is Q-axis. Okay, so this is under no load condition. Okay, now let us take the armature. Okay, let us take the armature in loaded condition. In loaded condition, with the field is unexcited. With field is unexcited means there is no main field flux. Okay, there is no main field flux. Now only consider armature conductors loaded. That means the current is flowing through the armature conductors. Okay, so this is one pole and this is another pole. Let us assume the current is going into the conductors under this pole, and let us assume the current is coming out of the paper from the, under this pole. So if you consider like this. The flux lines, because of the current flowing through the armature conductors, there will be flux around these conductors. So the flux lines are like this. So according to right hand thumb rule, okay, so it is going into, so the flux direction will be like this here. The flux direction will be like this here. So here it will be like this. So like this, and it will like this. And here also there will be flux lines. So here in this direction. Okay. So at this side it is like this. And here it is like this. Here it is like this. Okay. So this is when the machine is loaded with the field unexcited. Okay, so only the flux lines due to the current flowing through the armature conductors. Here it is, if you observe inside, so the flux lines are like this. So you can draw the phasor of the armature flux phi A in this direction. So it is again the polar axis or D axis. Okay, so GNA is like this. Okay, so now, so it will be north pole and it will be south pole. Okay, so inside the flux lines are like this. So it will become south pole and it will become north pole here due to armature flux. So if you give the field also excitation, so this north pole will attract this south pole. If it is a motor, so it will rotate in this direction. And it is a generator, we have to rotate in this direction. So that I want to tell. So if it is a motor, so it will rotate in this direction. If it is generator, we have to rotate in this direction. So inside the flux lines are like this, from that is this axis S pole and this axis north pole. Okay. So now if you combine these two, so when the loaded condition also there will be field, right? So we have to combine. Here we have not considered field. So if you combine these two, okay, if you combine these two, okay, so see here the field lines are like this. Okay, so if you consider at this point at this tip of the pole, okay, here the flux lines are like this, here also the flux lines are like this. Okay, so there is a more flux here. And if you consider the down tip, here the flux lines are like this, but the armature flux is like this. Okay, so both will be cancelled. Here there will be minimum flux. And similarly, here there will be minimum flux and here there will be maximum flux. Okay, so the total flux lines are like this. So it will coming like this and going like this. Okay, so this is a flux pattern. So the resultant flux is this one. So the effect of armature flux on the main field flux. So the total main field flux will be distorted like this. Sorry. The total main field flux is distorted like that. This pole tip there will be more flux, here there will be less flux, here again more flux, here again less flux. Okay, so now it is GNA is along the brush axis, it is always perpendicular to polar axis, and MNA is always perpendicular to the resultant flux. Now the resultant flux is like this, so MNA is perpendicular to this resultant flux, so this will be MNA. Okay, now if you draw the phasor diagram, so phi F is in this direction, phi A is in this direction from the previous ones. So now if you take the resultant of these two, so the net flux is in this direction here. This will be like this. So this is the resultant flux phi R. Okay. So now GNA is like this. So this is GNA. This is always perpendicular to polar axis. And now MNA is perpendicular to the resultant flux. So MNA is like this. This is MNA. This is perpendicular to resultant flux. So due to armature reaction, there is a shift in the magnetic neutral axis from this position to this position, right? So the amount of shift depends on the magnitude of the current flowing through the armature conductors. If more current is flowing, the MNA will shift more. Okay. If less current is flowing, the MNA shift is less. Okay. So this is about the armature reaction. Okay. So here there are two things will happen. One is the distortion of main flux. So here the main flux is like this, and here the main flux is distorted. So distortion of main field flux is called cross-magnetizing effect. Cross-magnetizing effect. Okay. So due to armature reaction, the first one happens is cross-magnetizing effect. Okay. And second one is, okay, and second one is second one is demagnetizing effect. So demagnetizing effect. So due to cross-magnetizing effect, due to the shift in the MNA, due to this flux, resultant flux is like this. Okay. So there will be commutation process will be difficult. That means sparking will occur at the brushes. The commutation process is not smooth because of this armature reaction, because of the cross-magnetizing effect. Okay. And the next one is demagnetizing effect. Okay. So here I told that the generator will rotate in this direction. Okay. So when the generator is rotating in this direction, this pole tip is called leading pole tip. Leading pole tip. And this is called trailing pole tip. Trailing pole tip. And similarly, so it is coming like this. So this will be the leading pole tip and this will be the trailing pole tip. Okay. So we can say that due to armature reaction, at the trailing pole tips, there will be strengthening of flux. And at the leading pole tips, there will be weakening of flux. Okay. So the trailing pole tips, there will be strengthening, and leading pole tips, there will be weakening of flux. So if you do not consider any saturation in the poles, if you do not consider any saturation in the poles, the amount of strengthening of the flux at the trailing pole tips is equal to the amount of flux weakening at the leading pole tips. If you do not consider saturation in the field poles, but there will always be a saturation in the field poles. So the effect of strengthening flux at the trailing pole tips is always less than the effect of weakening the flux at the leading pole tips. Understood? So the strengthening of flux is always less than the weakening of flux. So the net flux will be reduced from its no load value. The net flux will be reduced here from the no load value. So that is called demagnetizing effect. Demagnetizing means, so the net flux will be reduced from its no load value. So that is called demagnetizing effect. Due to demagnetizing effect, that means flux will be reduced. So obviously the EMF generated will be reduced in the generator, and in the motor, torque will be reduced. Okay. So that is the thing. So due to armature reaction, one will be cross-magnetizing effect, another will be demagnetizing effect. Due to cross-magnetizing effect, the commutation process is not smooth. There will be sparking at the brushes. And due to demagnetizing effect, there will be reduction in the EMF in the generator. There will be reduction in the torque in the motor. Thank you.